You notice you can't spin a fish? You just keep swimming. Just like you can't tune a fork or something like a camera.
That's cool.
Isn't that something?
Yesterday we talked about the latest craze with those crabs.
Yeah, the hermit crabs are just like off the charts popular. This was the last super big pet craze.
Siamese fighting fish.
Still
and they only
extremely popular.
They only separate the male.
What do you mean they only separate?
Only the males are separated in separate classes where the females can be together because we, of course, get along a lot better than you men do. Do you find it kind of dry in here? Like, I'm kind of parched.
Could use a drink.
Cheers.
Hot tub.
There's nothing quite like a bullfrog spa from Pools by Angelo.
Hot tub.
With its patented jetpack technology, you control where the water flows.
Hot tub.
Soak in the therapeutic bubbling waters. Relieve tension and stress with a soothing aqua body massage.
Hot tub.
Winter is the best time to unwind in warm water, and you don't have to fly south.
Come and see us at Pools by Angelo and become part of our family.
Pools by Angelo, Windsor's hot tub headquarters.
Now tell me that's not one of the most beautiful things that you could see, and you can have it in your home just by stopping here at Corbett's, and Dennis will help them out and put this into your home.
And I sure will.
If it suits the home, though, because you've got to have the space as well, I would
There's
imagine.
Different design aquariums for different needs of the home. If you're limited in a room, we got stuff that are compact and are visually aesthetic. And if you have a limited room, like column aquariums,
okay.
Corner tanks now.
Okay, very good.
Bow front corners, hexagons. We got hanging the wall tanks. We got everything.
Now, what's really cool, this seems to be the thing right now. I mean, gone are the days. I shouldn't say gone are the days, but this is more popular than you would have your goldfish where, you know, when you and I were growing up, the goldfish was the big
thing. Even the kids these days want Nemo. They want salt water.
Salt
water. The day of the goldfish is gone.
What are we seeing in this particular tank right now?
This is a coral reef setup. These are all live corals. You got your bubble corals, your little polyps, your cold corals, the moving one with the hands there. It's called Gonapora. I know it sounds like a disease, but it's an actual name.
I mean, yesterday we had crabs, and today we've got what?
Gonapora.
Gonapora. Okay, what is this thing over here?
That's called a remora shark. It's not an actual shark, but it hangs out underneath sharks, and as sharks are grabbing their prey and tearing them apart, they're like the scavengers. You'll always see about a six to a dozen underneath the shark collecting scraps.
Is that ever neat? Yeah. And beside it over here, this...
That's called a black ribbon eel. It's actually pretty gentle, but it looks menacing.
It does.
Yes.
Now its mouth is open.
That's the way it breathes.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Now, I have to ask you this, because earlier I was looking at this, and I did something that I've been told you're not supposed to do, that kids do all the time.
Tap on glass.
We shouldn't be tapping on glass.
Exactly. It's like someone putting a pail on your head and tapping on the pail.
And how
they get that reverberation.
Do you like that? What's neat over here, I don't know if you can get this, Mike, but these are probably some of the most colorful.
Very
fish
pastel.
Right in there.
That's called the Royal Gramma.
Nice. And again, we can continue going. Now, you've got a special name for this yellow and blue
one. This is my favorite
one.
Here, the yellow and blue one. It's called the Bicolor Angel, but we call it the U of M fish.
Apparently, someone's a good big U of M fan.
A little bit.
You know what? Hey,
that Red Wings and Spitz.
Do you have a Red Wing fish?
Well, as closest as the blood shrimp.
That is
He's full but deadly if it's antagonized, as the crocodile hunter found out.
Now,
but at this size and the smaller, the needle is not there. The venom is not there.
So the likelihood of it.
They're actually very, very peaceful. I mean, you really have to antagonize it for anything like that to ever happen. They'll eat out of your fingers. They become very personable. Eat bits of shrimp. Like you see some shrimp still floating there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. That's one of the
lion.
The best looking fish you can possibly get for saltwater, but it's the deadliest, too.
Really?
Actually, I was on the front page of the Windsor Star. I got stung by one. If you have a fish like this, just be careful. They will not come after you. They will not bite you. They'll come at you and sting you. You have to physically grab the fish for that to happen. It's very pretty.
What is it that stings you?
The top dorsal.
Okay.
They're like needles, injection needles. They come
really?
Up. Yeah.
How big will this get, or is this the biggest it will get?
No, it'll still get it'll get up to anywhere 16 inches.
Do you
very
put anything
clear.
In with that?
You can put anything that it can't fit in its mouth.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, that frightens me.
It is a carnivore.
Let's take a look at this guy.
That's called an Oscar. He just ate about a dozen goldfish.
Is that why he's laying down there?
He's digesting.
He's like most men after they've eaten.
Thanksgiving dinner.
Yeah, exactly. Laying there, not doing anything. The only thing that's missing is his hand in his pants.
Yeah.
Other than that, I meant it like Al Bundy, where he puts his hand right here.
These are called black ghosts.
And the black ghosts, they like to have fun with each other as well.
Oh, yeah. They chase each other around like kids. There's Dory.
Unbelievable. I can't
straight from the movie.
I need an autograph currently. At least my kids would say if I didn't get one, I'd be in trouble. But there's also Nemo just down here as well.
Yeah, Nemo's just right up here.
And then right beside.
That is called a cleaner shrimp.
They'll
physically get on a fish, clean parasites on them. They'll even get into the mouth and clean their teeth or palates. They're known as the dentist of the ocean.
Really?
Amazing. Yeah. Even aggressive fish will allow them into their mouth.
Just to clean. Just to clean they pretty much, them. It just eats the scraps that's left.
Except they don't give you a bill like a dentist.
Yeah, exactly. A lot cheaper.
This is just a pup. This is called the bamboo shark. He eats shrimp and small goldfish. They'll get about 16 feet in length. They actually ride these down in Florida in the Caribbean on the side fins, and they'll take you for a cruise.
Are you serious?
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Do they not hurt you?
One. If you put your finger towards their mouth where they feel it, they give you a little nibble down there. But
this isn't like your typical great white.
Not like Jaws. No.
Oh. That's what I thought. And speaking of, it's feeding time, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Okay. Well, it's feeding time. And although I'd like to feed Bevan to this fish because of what he's done, let's feed him what he's supposed to eat.
We got mini Bevans.
Mini Bevans. Let me see. Oh, look at him go right for it.
Hi, Bev.
Oh.
Mind that.
Wow. He was hungry.
Hey, you know what? Dennis is right. This is a good way to teach the kids not to tap on the glass. Isn't that something? Oh, I knew that was coming. Hey, do you wonder, do fish ever get sick of seafood? Just one.
Somebody help me, seriously. Somebody help me. Two locations to serve you best, here on Walker Road and one on Tecumseh Road as well. And somebody, get rid of him.
That's a lot of fish. That's like having like five hamburgers.
Oh, yeah.